I'm just gonna throw my two cents in here because I feel like one of the biggest issues is not being addressed in this whole Athlene X scandal. And that is, to look like an athlete, you gotta train like an athlete. What does that even mean? Because I'll tell you what, Jeff Cavalier does not look like an athlete, right? He looks, he looks more like a marathon runner. And I bring this up, and this, because I think it's just a really important topic for fellow athletes all around the world. I mean, if you got 10 million subscribers and that is your motto, look like an athlete, train like an athlete, to look like whatever it is, you're misleading all the athletes. Because I've been a strength coach, and one of the most common questions is, well, how can I get, I want to get bigger and stronger, but I don't want to like get fatter. It's like, guys, listen, it's not possible. It's the great white buffalo. The only way that's possible is with cattle substances. You know what I mean? You can't get bigger and stronger and more lean, right? That is the $1 million question, the gazillion dollar question in the fitness industry. If people had the answer for that, then there's nothing to figure out. There wouldn't need to be any channels of all this stuff and whatever. You would have the answers. You would have the answers. So let's take a look at the facts here. I don't know. I looked it up his stats and it's like 6 to 8% body fat or something like that. He's 180 pounds or something along those lines. So if we just think about this logically, what happens if he goes to actually athletic body fat, 12, 14% body fat? What is he gonna be? That, cause he's all sucked down right now. How much is he benching then? 400 plus pounds for reps on a harder movement? You know what I'm saying? Like, just think about it from a logical point of view. And I just have to address this because I almost get this comment every single day. Wow, you look really good at this period. You should go back to doing that. But it's like, I was 20 pounds lighter and my deadlift and bench were about 100 pounds weaker. And I actually want to be athletic and be strong. You can't be shredded to the bone and strong. So basically, that's all I'm gonna say about the matter, because that's something that I feel like it really is misleading to the people, because at the end of the day, everyone wants to get bigger and stronger and leaner. So if you have a spokesperson that's teaching you all the secrets of how to look like an athlete, 6% body fat, 2x body weight bench press, it's not gonna happen, guys. I was a part of Big Ten Division I NCAA wrestling. All right, I think I understand a thing or two about being lean and being sucked down and being emaciated. And it's actually perfect because I wrestled at 184 pounds my first 3 years of college. And it was about 5-6% body fat. You know what I was benching? And keep in mind, this is after 10 years of lifting. I was benching about 185 pounds for reps, right? I couldn't even bench 225. And then when I decided not to cut weight and that it was killing me and I was weak and emaciated, I bumped up to 220 pounds. And then my bench went from 185 to 315. And you know why that is? Body fat, right? Energy, reserves, having a little puffiness, not being sucked down, not being emaciated. You can't be emaciated and be strong. And I think just that's the main issue. You know, everyone's talking about like, you know, selling programs and all that, and like that's whatever, and the illusion that you're stronger to sell the programs. But I think the biggest issue that needed to be addressed was, if you want to be strong, you have to be a little soft. And that's just the fact of the matter. But everything is getting twisted online on the internet because you can't tell how big people are, right? The smaller, leaner people look the biggest online. You got guys 160 to 180 pounds that, oh my God, I want to look like that guy. But then you see him in person and they look like this, right? There's no thickness to them. And then you got the 250 pound people that are like, oh, it doesn't even look like, you look terrible. You don't look like, you don't even lift, right? But that's the thing about the internet. That's the real athletes. The people on the internet that look like they don't even lift are the real athletes, because they actually have a little fat layer that's going to make them strong and powerful. That is really what looking like an athlete is all about. So anyways, that's it on the matter. I just want you guys to realize that, because I do get comments on the regular about, oh, you should get back to, you know, like, you should really get caught up and stuff. But do you understand that you can't have your cake and eat it too? You can't get a free ride. You can't get strong and sliced and diced. It just doesn't work that way. It's one or the other. And that's why back in the day, bodybuilders would bulk and then cut, because that's kind of how you do it. And now it's like everyone's so disillusioned by all these drugs that, because that's what people look at, athletes and stuff. I gotta go online, I gotta see this guy's strong and shredded to the bone. But you can't. Why do you think all the strongest powerlifters, Olympic weightlifters, strongmen, do any of them look like these physique, right? These aesthetics guys? Because it's not the real world. So just think about that.